Hello everyone, my name is Manjit Singh and I'm a legal intern at Lexis & Company. I'm a third year LLB student of Lloyd Law College. And today's my topic is relation of the President and Prime Minister in India. Now, the President of India does not get elected directly as the Prime Minister. Instead, his election is indirect through an electoral college which consists of members of both House of Parliament and the elected members of the Vidhan Sabha and the Union Territories. The President plays a role in influencing the various policies and different actions taken by the government moderately. There is no initiation of any actions on his own. When it comes to terms related to the provision of the Constitution, however, there is undoubtedly no wonder that the office of the President is of the immense weight of such high importance and a position of pride and honor that it cannot easily be cast aside by the PM. The relation between the Prime Minister and the President is of a great importance, as it's the PM who keeps his eyes intact to the ground, through which the President acquires the pulse of the people. The President must be informed regarding the happening and working of all the departments, especially those revolving around the initiation of the various policies. Now let us move to the President. The President of India appoints another officer who holds constitutional post, as well as some other vital members of the central government, such as first one is Prime Minister, second one is the Council of Minister of the PM advice on the PM's advice, the Chief Minister of India, along with the other apex courts of High Court judges upon the CGI advice, and other members of the National Commissions and UPSCs, etc. Now let us move to the President's power. The President of India can grant pardon, reprieve, remit, amity, remission of a person. He can also in some instant minimize the sentence of death of person who is offended, mainly regarding the case that revolves around the punishment related to the death, that is under Article 72, deals with the pardoning power of the President. The legislative power of the President. Bills can only become the law when he passes them. Also, he can promulgate ordinance even when the Parliament is not in session. The President is also entitled to command the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha and can lead to their dissolution. Now let us move to the PM. The PM of India has the following powers by being the head of the Union of Council of Ministers. First one is, it is on the PM's recommendation that the President appoints minister, that is Council of Ministers. PM is the presiding officers of the various meeting of Council of Ministers. Also, his decision plays a influencing role. And PM may ask any minister to give the resignation at any time, or else it is upon the advice that the President dismisses any minister mainly when difference in opinion occurs. And allocation and reshuffling of portfolio among various ministers take place by the PMs only. In short, the ministers are individually and collectively responsible to the Prime Minister, and also they can swim and sink together. The PM is considered to the head of the Union Government as per the Indian Constitution. During the Hung Parliament, the role of the President gains much importance, although the executive functions performed by the government are taken and executed by in President's name. However, there are no specific files that do not reach them. After going through the powers of the President and the Prime Minister and the functioning of the Prime Minister and the PM, we can conclude that it can be summed up that the relationship between the President and the PM is instead complex yet managing. They enjoy equal power and position, which is of high importance and needed for the proper functioning of the government machinery, for maintenance and the managing and upholding the principle upheld in the Constitution and ensuring India as the largest democracy. Thank you. This was all about the relationship between the Prime Minister and the PM. Please like, subscribe and comment on my channel as well as on my video. डू कमेंट्स योर क्वेश्चंस ऑन द कमेंट बॉक्स. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस विद रिगार्ड्स टू माय दिस वीडियो और विद रिगार्ड्स टू माय प्रीवियस वीडियो. लास्टली दिस वीडियो डज नॉट सॉलिसिट एनी काइंड्स ऑफ प्रमोशन एज पर द गाइडलाइंस इशू बाय द बार काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया. द सोल पर्पज ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज फॉर द एजुकेशनल पर्पज ओनली. थैंक यू.